Hello everyone and welcome to this episode of the Sarcastic Prophet. I wanted to show you real quick on siege weapons. In case you didn't know, you start off in this area here, your actual main citadel. Of course, there's one of three. You have the red, the purple, and the green. I'm on the green this side. We're of course getting our butts kicked, but I'd like to at least show you before the beta is up on what to do. Now what you'll do is you want to look for a siege merchant. Like, you'll see the little siege merchant icons here. There's also one at each citadel. From there, you're going to want to get supply. As you can see, the caravans are used to repair, upgrade guards, walls, and build siege equipment. So this took me a little bit of time to figure this out, but what I'll do is run and show you what I've done so far. So just outside the gate, there should be, I think it's the same for all, I'm not sure. I haven't done enough of this to know. But there'll be a siege merchant over here. Of course, there's several. I need to repair my gear. A lot of it's broken, but it doesn't really matter.
How interesting.
And then over here, you'll see the outfitter, trait master, and siege master here.
All prices are non-
and then you can purchase, you know, the flame ram. So I'm able to damage walls. Of course, the arrow cart is, I've seen this thing in other videos where it just murders groups of people and turning the tide of battle. The ballista blueprints is used to, of course, to damage the siege equipment and infantry. I don't see how much on infantry. These things are really slow to turn. So the catapult, I built one. Hopefully it's still up and I can show it to you. And of course, the trebuchet, which is a very, very long range weapon. And then the Alpha Siege Golem, which is really cool. But I have yet to see one of these things out. And it costs gold to bring that out right now. So what you do is when you buy it, as you can see, it requires, like this one requires 30 supply. This one requires 20 supply, 40 supply. The one that I picked up required 50 supply. Trebuchet needs 100 supply, and then 100 supply for the Alpha Siege Golem. Of course, this is beta. This is subject to change. Once you pick up the blueprint, then you'll have to run and pick up some supply. Now for me, you can, you know, you'll have to actually go to a supply camp. So what I'll do is run real quick. I've got 6 on me from when I was helping build a flame arrow turret and another catapult. What I'll do is I run over here real quick. So that way you can see what one of these camps look like. Of course, if you've played PvP in our World vs. World, this is old hat, you already know. But I had to learn, and of course others will too, and this will speed the process up a little bit further if you see this video. That gate's useful for getting back up. You can come down, but the tiers won't let you back up. So you can see these barrels. So this is where the supply actually is. And you can carry, from what I can see, 10 at a time. So I pick it up, you get some supply, and as you can see, you know, 96 of 100. Now there's 100 of 100. It recharged pretty fast because we're at our actual citadel base. Here comes a caravan. I'm not sure. Can you actually pick it up from these guys? No, it actually has to go to the actual camp. So that one will actually travel, I believe. I'm not sure what it actually will travel to. Anyway, we've been fighting over this for the longest time. Looks like they actually broke the wall. I'm going to head down there. I think I still have a catapult up. I'd like to show it. Hopefully it's still up. Oh, I have to go through the gate, actually. This prevents people from sneaking around. here. And I don't think you want to see me run the whole way, so I'm going to go ahead and fast forward. Okay, now I'm closer. Hopefully I won't die horribly sliding down this mountain ledge. Ooh, that was close. You can see some of these guys are already using catapults to try to attack. Oh wow, do we have a trebuchet up? Where did that fireball... Yeah, there it is. Look at that range on that thing. That's just incredible. This is probably too far away, but when you select an actual siege engine, you'll get a list of options. Turning it, as you can see, you can slowly turn. You can load, usually they'll have a secondary shot which will allow you to fire at infantry, then you actually have your siege fire. When you actually press the button, you'll actually notice a little line. If you do it short, it's wimpy, and down it goes. But if you hold down a long time, it'll travel really, really far. There it goes. But it's still, it's a trebuchet, it's the catapult. Oh, the wall just went down. But that's how that works. Now if I can switch to gravel shot, you can see here it's going to fire the gravel and then burst into several smaller pieces. I'll show you here. It wasn't far enough range. Looks like she's not doing it this time. God. They've been at this for quite a while, so they're obviously... Uh-oh. Someone's getting jumped over here. Get him back. He did this to me earlier. Got him. Ha ha ha. I have to laugh at him. He hates that. He keeps trying to kill me. It's the same guy. And I always seem to show up at the wrong time. Anyway, this was the catapult that I built down here. You'll see some... When you actually lay it down... You'll get some options here, you'll lay it down, and you'll see some construction materials, and you gotta bring in. I took down this wall. It was kind of a nice flanking maneuver. Everyone was on the main gate. I flanked. Another guy put up his catapult. I mean, two catapulted this wall down. I'm able to flank through. That's what they're doing here now. Looks like they managed to repair the damage, though. But that's how, basically, siege engines work, and how... It's important. Oh wow, that wall is... I thought it was already down. But you can see how resources work. How... there it goes. Bam! That's incredible to see that fall. Oh boy. Alright, here we go. We're going to charge in. And he'd probably get murdered, but... They were out of supply anyway. You can see there's no crates here. Zero supply of 1700. They had upgraded this place big time. Oh, I can't kill them. Okay. Well, we're in, though. We've been trying to get in here for a long time. Whoa, that was a massive explosion. You can see we've been working on that door. Oh, sorry about the FPS. And now they're on the inner keep. Oh, this may still not go very well for us. Oh, I hit a trap of some kind. Just want to go up here real quick. Ah. This one was shooting at me earlier. And what I just did was lay down this radiation field, just in case something pops up on us. And then a healing turret. As you can see, these things stay in the persistence, so if you don't get rid of them, they can come back and haunt you. Got some people out here. That same guy again. How do they repair that? Don't know how he did that, but he managed to pull that off. Anyway, my frame rate is just absolutely getting murdered right now, so we're gonna go ahead and explode and stop.